Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the SIM architecture. Okay, what is meant by SIM architecture? First of all, what is meant by SIM? Okay, so SIM is a utility or a tool, or it can be a software like Splunk, or it can be hardware where some software is installed on it. Okay, all your organization logs are sent to that location. Okay, it is also some sort of what do you say, a box, okay, or a server, anything you can say it. Okay, it'll also have some sort of memory, okay, I mean like storage. Okay, it'll also have some sort of storage device, like I am showing it now. Okay, it'll be having some storage. Okay. This particular storage will store all the logs. Okay, whenever you want, you can use those logs. And what and all you can do? You can create dashboards. Dashboard means like it will gives you overview about what's happening in your organization at a higher level. Okay, and also it will give you you can also create reports. Means some reports you can create like in PDF or Excel or something like that, and you can share it with your managers or your team members, or you can give it for some auditing department or something like that. You can create some reports, all those whatever the dashboards you create, or yourself you can create some, write some queries and get those reports and share it with some team where you want. Or you using this SIM, you can create alerts also. Alerts means something is bad happening in your organization. For that, you have like created some query, and if that query gets satisfied and you have written some condition, like if there is a failed login attempt, okay, for that you have created some alert. Failed login attempts, if it is like more than condition you have kept like more than 5 times, so during that time it creates an alert. Just not for one single failed login from a system. It generate doesn't create any alert, but if you have written a condition like say 5 failed login attempts within 1 minute of time, so that actually helps us in creating an alert. That is called as an alert. So using SIM, you can do all these things. Okay, you can. This is a SIM. Okay, this SIM can be like, as I said, it can be some, what do you say, SIM vendors in the market. There are so many people are there, like these, like ArcSight. Okay, you have McAfee, you have QRadar, you have what else? I'll tell Splunk at the end. I'll tell QRadar, and you also have someone, example, RSA, NetWitness. Okay, so RSA NetWitness. Okay, and these are actually the security products, but Splunk is also there, but I would like to distinguish separately. Okay, Splunk. There
So
is something called.
solar wind also used, right? Like for
Yes,
tracking
yes, yes,
network.
yes, 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 yes. Correct. That's true. Okay. So there is something called as logarithm. I might be something wrong. Okay. Rhythm. Logarithm. Okay. Logarithm. Okay. And also you have something called as solar winds. These are different
Tools, yeah.
security focused tools, but Splunk is also there. But Splunk is actually a tool which collects and analyzes for logs, not only for security, even for your like web server, something like analytics you want to do, what's happening with your sales database related thing, something you want to do, everything you can do using the Splunk. But we are using it as like for our purpose as security. Okay. So Splunk directly you can use it for what do you say, analytic tool, and using it as a Splunk. But if someone asks you what is Splunk? You have to say it as Splunk is a
Analytic.
analytical tool. Okay, but most of the people, 60% of the people, they use this data because it's easy. Okay, compared to any of these things, but these are directly focused on security only. Okay, but this is analytical tool, but we are converted it as our security tool. Okay, and everyone will have some database where you can store the logs, and you have to write queries. Queries means some short form of information that you give, that your database understand, and using that you can create the dashboards or reports or alerts. But to access this thing, okay, first you have to, what do you say, you have to create the query. Okay, so the query you have to write, for those logs to access, and then you convert them into either dashboards, reports, or alerts. Okay, so remember, the main use of either Splunk or any other security operation tools like SIMs, like ArcSight, McAfee, QRadar, RSA, or LogRhythm, or SolarWind, everything, the main objective is to create dashboards, create reports, and creating the alerts. Is it clear for you guys now?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. Let me move further. Okay. So now, before we getting deep dive into these particular things, I just want to bring some hints up for you guys. Okay. So usually, why we need SIM, first of all. Okay. So to come to that conclusion, before to that, we need to understand why we have taken that approach to get into the SIM. So like, I'm talking about little old data, say for example, till 2017, okay, if any organization, it can be a small organization or it can be a very big organization, any organization, okay, if any breach happens, breach means something, someone has attacked and something happened in the background, but the company doesn't even know. But how much time it is taking for them to come to know about that? They already under attack, or they already attack happened and they have come to know about this now, something like that. Somewhere around 99 days it was happening. Okay, it was taking around the 99. Now the problem is, it is taking so many days, means like it is very hard for an organization to come to know that. It's not like, even though if you have firewalls, even though if you have like IDS, IPS kind of some security devices, even though if you have web application firewalls, even though you have antivirus installed, okay, but still attacks are happening, and it is taking a lot of time for the organizations to realize. Even though some cases, those companies which are got compromised, they also have SOC already in place. Okay, they already have SOCs also. SOC, Security Operations Center team, is in place. Security Operations Center is nothing but like a team, like our IT team, who comes and whenever they come, they take care of our network related things or installation, and some NOC teams will be there, which they'll be looking after the traffic that is coming in and going out from the network perspective. Is there any network down, or it's something like shutdown of any interface or something like that? Like, interface means the internet, wherever it is going into some or some traffic going into some router or switch or something, somewhere it went down or something like that, they will be taking care. Same way, Security Operations Center, what they do, they take care of like who is entering into various systems like firewalls, web servers, or Windows servers, or all these things. They will be keeping track who is coming in and who is going out, and they will be created. They might have created some dashboards to continuously see Like if there is any abnormal pattern of traffic is happening, like say for example, I can say the usual the usual way if it is something like this, say for example, graph should be something like this. But unfortunately, what happened is usually graph should be like this, okay? But unfortunately, what happened is graph something, it either either it went, yeah, either it went up like this, okay? Okay, either it went up like this, okay? Or sometimes it might have come down. Okay, or sometimes it is like all of a sudden there is something, it went up like this and it came. What happened over here? Like these are things and all, you can see it in the dashboard. This might be something related to web traffic or some router traffic or something. What is the cause here? Okay, is this expected? Because usually night times it will be slow, little less like this. All of a sudden morning it will go up like this and continue, and by evening again slowly it will reduce, because people will leave from the office, or people will there be anything like entire night people will be buying the products? No. So during that times traffic will be low. The morning times, this say for example, this is night 12 p.m. to next somewhat like 10 p.m. logs, okay, it should look like this, because at 6 a.m. okay, slowly this will increase, and by 10 a.m. it will be on peak, and the same amount of somewhere around near it will be continued, and slowly after 6 again it will be slowly coming down till 9, and it will continue like this, okay? So these kind of patterns they'll be looking at various things like rotor, switch, all these things, okay? Just a glance I have given you how the graph looks, okay? So they'll be monitoring like this. But even though they are looking all those things, but most of the cases the attacks are happening, means like people are not able to identify, even though you have NOC and SOC in place, network operation control and security operation control, and you have antivirus, you have all those things are there, but still like you have firewalls are there to contain them, and you have threat intelligence related information is also there in them, like WAF or in WAF or in firewall, anywhere it is like who is bad actor. I know IP addresses, list of IP addresses of bad actors, latest attackers IP addresses, okay? But still they might somehow get in and compromise you, okay? So this is very unfortunate thing, but the attacks are happening, okay? So as I said, it is like it takes in 2017, it takes around 99 days, okay? But is that like very bad thing, right? Okay, so it's like only like I can say like this kind of thing is accepted. Certainly you cannot avoid it. If attack has to happen, means it might have, but you should be in a proactive mode, in the sense you should be able to contain those attacks before they actually happens. At least from your side, all the things you should take care in place. And one of the most sad part of it, okay, like in these actually whatever it is, the days, like it takes 99 days, right? In them also, 49% of those, 49%, 40 to 50%, 45 to 50%, means exactly 47%, 47% of those organizations, okay, like out of 100 organizations, okay, say 47% of those organizations doesn't even have SOCs. So that means like nearly 50% of the chances that you are, because of you don't have SOC, you are getting compromised, okay? And in that also, like 47%, but in these like 100%, whatever these got compromised, right? In these 100%, 57% of them, okay, who are having socks also, who are having like 53%, right? In that 57%, who are like having less sock skills. Sock is there, but they don't have skills. Okay. But in that, only 21% are properly utilizing. So that's what the stats says. Okay. Like Mandian, EY, Ernst & Young. These companies are like some auditing companies. Okay. They give us the some sort of what do you say? Some reports on how the attackers are actually, what percentage of the companies are getting attacked. These kind of reports they'll be releasing. Okay. So for everything, as I said, everything whichever I said here does require something. Okay, to come to know whether the attack is happening or attack is already happened. All such things to get to know, you require something. Okay, what it is? The fuel. Okay, the fuel is what for this particular thing? It is logs, or you have to say it as data. Okay, so what type of data it is required to get to know about if something is happening? Immediately you should be notified, or at least if the attack is in progress, at least you should know. Because if there is no monitoring system like SOC kind of thing in place, it's very hard for you to even come to know that that's something happening in the background without knowing to you. So SOC should be there, but you need data for that. For SOC team, it requires data to collect from different log sources, like right from firewall logs, router logs, switches logs, and IDS log, IPS logs, or WAF logs, application server logs, Windows server logs, Active Directory logs, database logs, all these things you require, antivirus logs, all these logs required. Okay, but how much of amount of logs it is required? That is also important. You require logs, but how much amount of the logs? The problem is when you are starting a SIM, okay, or if you want like to analyze, your organization might be like having 10,000 like or 1 lakh servers or 10,000 servers, something like that it is there. Okay, these are huge numbers of servers. Okay, there are companies which are having almost 100,000 servers, 10,000 servers, 20,000 servers, I've seen it. But the problem is like holding all those things and monitoring it from a view, it is too much, because people will have to monitor everything. It is not possible. I have to openly say it as bluntly, it is not possible. But you should focus, okay, on important assets. Means where the critical data is present, focus on them rather than on everything. Okay, so that's why we have something called as you have to focus on critical. But if you only focus on the critical data, if you focus on only on critical data, like say for example where your database, where your critical data is there, if you only looking into that, it is very little. Okay, but that amount of data, you cannot like come to a conclusion to 100% that you are successfully monitoring, because you have very little data. Okay, with this data, and if you have too much data, human resource problem, like resources problem, the people like with 10 people entire organization, or 20 people with the entire organization, or 50 people with are 100 people with 10,000 assets, it's very hard to manage even for a SOC team. So that's why what you have to be, you should be very intelligent. Okay, you should not be at a position very low data you have or too much data you have, but you should have right data. Okay, right data. Let's see what and all that write data and all after some time. But remember, write data is important. So for doing all these things, you have to plan your SIM. Okay? You have to plan your SIM. So you bought a SIM. Okay? You are going to planning to buy a SIM. Okay? So first of all, two things important for any organization. Okay? Is your business, does your business comes requires for you to have to follow any compliance like financial compliance, like ISO compliance? Okay, all these things. ISO says like all your company activity, whatever it is happening, to be stored in a centralized server. Whatever your Windows logs, Linux logs, everything must be stored. Whether you have SOC or you don't have SOC, that things you have to store, okay, in a database. Okay, so that particular thing is called as compliance. Here you are not monitoring them, just storing them. Okay, everything, whatever it is, the traffic coming in, going out, everything you are storing here. So compliance, it requires for you to store all org data. Okay, it depends the type of company. Or financial companies, they say like you must store this data for 360 days or like 5 years or something like that. Okay, so is it possible continuously store like this? Whatever the different systems they are sending the logs for compliance sake, how much memory it requires for you? Okay, too much, but 5 years they say to store it. So what we'll do is we have two types of storages. One is cold and hot. Hot means like 60 days you keep it in the tool wherever the compliance for that particular sake, you can actually buy some database and you can use them. 60 days as soon as when people can actually connect to this machine and run some query and get the data, kind of Splunk kind of thing. Okay, 60 days. And after 60 days, every date, I mean like every logs which are beyond 60 days old, greater than 60 days things, store in like zip them and store it in archive. We will say rather than zip, archive them and store in some location. Okay, permanently. Okay, you have to keep them for 5 years, because if anything happens, like say for example after 2 years, so you can go here, take this. Okay, and you can, if they want to know like what happened like 2 years before something, they can get this data from here and they can analyze it. Oh, some attacker has came or some financial transaction, something fraud happened, they can come and check the logs here. Okay, so that is the way we have. This is cold, this is hot. So 60 days you'll store here, and immediately after the 60 days it'll over, you archive them and send them to some different storage that is called as cold storage. Okay, whenever you want to cold storage data, you bring them back here into the hot storage and use them. Okay, using Splunk queries or anything. Just example I'm telling you. Okay, so now you come to know, right? Cold and hot. Okay, this is called as. So this is called as compliance related activities. Here you are doing any security related things? No. If some auditing company comes, people comes, if they ask you like show me some 30 days before data, means you will show it from here. If they ask you like I want router logs 2 years before, then they will show it from here. That is for compliance. Okay, compliance, it cannot be used for tactical purpose. Means like I want to use this compliance data and see like what's happening within our organization in real time, that and all, it is not possible. Okay, so that's why compliance is not, that's why what we'll do is, okay, we will go for SIM. Okay, some organizations, what they do is in SIM itself, what they do is they will give you hot storage. Okay, and they will use some other some system or something to push those old logs to cold storage. So it satisfied your compliance related thing, and as well as it satisfied your SOC related monitoring, whatever the things it requires. So SOC uses SIM, okay, to monitor. So now you can use tactically. This became tactically. So this has got all security related features to identify threats, right? Those all functionalities are there here. But here you don't have security related identification features, okay? Here, like threat detection features are not there. Threat detection not available. So threat detection available. Like it gives you the feasibility of creating the dashboards, alerts, and reports, everything you can do it from here. Okay. So this is about like what is meant by compliance and why we are going for the SIM. Okay. But let's see. Now, what we can do, we can let's plan the SIM. You are going to buy the SIM. Okay. How we are going to plan it, how we are going to buy it. Now you have come to know your organization requires whether what kind of company you are. So if it is like compliance requirements, you have to make sure some extra space also to be required for you to whatever the hot storage logs you are collecting, you have to send them after 60 days or 30 days to the cold storage by zipping them or archiving them. Okay, you are storing in one location. Okay, now you are gathering the data. There is like how many ways you can actually collect the logs. Okay, what is your approach in collecting the logs? Okay, there are three types of approaches where you can three strategies you can go for it. First, input driven. Okay, input driven. What is meant by input driven? As I said earlier, you have 100 systems are there. Okay. All 100 systems data, if you have to collect, okay, this is called as input driven. Okay. There is something called as output driven. Okay. Now, what happens in input driven means you will launch all the systems, okay, start collecting at the all logs of the systems at the same time, at the same amount of time, and start working on them, and you will start working on them, okay, on those logs. Because of this, okay, since you are looking all the logs at the same amount of time in the SIM, you will see a lot of unnecessary false alerts, alarms will rise. Because like whether it is false positive or it is really an issue or whether it is not an issue, all those things you don't know. Okay, so false positive means the error is there, but it is not affecting
trace. Not traced,
not traced. It is not hurting you, or I can say that maybe some malfunction of the server, this alert might have raised. Okay, say for example, if there is for 5 minutes you have written some code, right? You have written some rule alert in your SIM that for 1 minute, if the logs are not coming from a system, alert should be raised. Okay, you are getting right what I'm saying. From a system, for a period of 1 minute, if you are not received any log from a system, okay, then you raise an alert to SOC. So SOC team will get in touch and see the SIM. Okay, or from which system I have got alert. Okay, from so and so system I have not received log, then I will check the router logs or switch logs. Okay, then I'll come to know that for this system, okay, from past more than 1 minute, there is no logs only coming. This system is not active only. So that time, are any logs, this web server, no customers only have not come. So that time, the web server logs are doesn't come here itself, okay, in the first place. So it is a false positive. In the sense, the alert is correct, but it is not an attack. Okay, it is something which is not anticipated thing. Correct, right? Something which is like really, there is no traffic, web traffic from external world to this web server. So you are monitoring the web logs here. And for 1 minute, you have told that no logs are coming from this web logs are coming from this server. Alert me. And you go went and checked it. Yes, it is a alert only. It is a positive thing. Okay, that alert is positive. But when you checked it is a false thing because the logs itself not received, generated because of no traffic only to this web server from the external internet or within your organization. Someone is trying to access this web pages or something like that. Okay, this is called as false positive. True positive means alert happened. Okay, this system might have shut down. Okay, and you have clearly mentioned that 1 minute if nothing is coming means let me know. The system has shut down. You don't know why it is shut down. That is called as true positive. Okay. And the other part is attacker might have disabled the logs. Okay. That is also true positive. True positive means really there is something. Alert is triggered, but it is really true. That's why we say it as like true positive, or it is like yes, attack is there. You can say it as. False positive means yes, attack is there. Positive means yes, alert is there, but it is not an attack traffic. Or you, when you investigate, it is something like it is a way the rule is triggered is correct, but there is no traffic or something. Take that as one example.
But there is no impact. There is no impact on the organization.
Yeah. No impact for the organization. Okay.
So can we here, say like can
yeah,
we say
ahead.
Like alert generated? But the logs, what you are expecting is not generally some kind of different logs. So that can be false positive.
I'll tell. Okay. Misconfiguration someone has done on that particular server. Still, it is a true positive, because if there is not getting the logs means someone has reconfigured something, some different port or something means you should be notified. But they have not notified you. That is a serious thing. You have to consider it as an incident. You have to, as soon as when you get a true incident, okay, true positive, then you have to start following up the investigation. Okay, like incident, you have to take care of that, like towards the closer, like who has done it. You have to proceed with the investigation, your investigation, your own investigation, which system, which team has actually modified it, why they have modified those configurations, that port is not sending the logs. Okay, earlier you might be sending it from 9997 something. Okay, you are sending the logs port this system. They have changed it to 8888 without knowing to you, they have done it. Okay, it is trying to send, but it is not sending now this system. Then that is definitely an impact for you, right? Okay, so instead of like sending here web logs, if they are sending some other logs, as you asked, that is also an impact, because the queries, everything, whatever you have written, you created dashboard, they might be receiving some junk data which is not required for you, but you have to look at web service logs. Okay, but you might be looking at you might be receiving some because of the folder location change, they might be pointing to syslogs or something. So those are also not useful. Okay. So all these things you have to take care. That is true positive and false positive things. Okay. Let me. So now this is clear, right? True positive, false positive, what it is.
Yes.
Yeah. Now input driven, what I mean to say here is, okay, you are collecting all the logs from different machines. Okay. All the logs. Okay, the input driven strategy, once you start collecting everything from each device, okay, why you are collecting, okay, because you are hoping that slowly I will make sure, okay, I want every log to be collected. If you don't collect everything, you might miss like what is happening with the organization. If any other assets, even though they are not critical systems, you don't know what might happen to that. Say for example, here this is an application server. Okay, here you have to collect syslogs, okay, which is a Linux machine, and you have to collect Apache logs because application server it is. Some application is installed, web application. So both logs it has to be sent separately. Okay, so if you are sending this here also system logs, web application logs, here antivirus logs, and it is like syslogs also there, like some on Linux machine. This is Windows logs, Windows server, and along with that Active Directory is installed. So like that it is. So you will be like for every log you are collecting and like you are trying to manage the SIM, because it is too much data for you. You have you are collecting for the security purpose. Okay, like if you are collecting all the Windows logs, say for example, like successful logs, failure logs, any small thing happens also you are collecting. So from a system, okay, everything you are collecting, that is called as you are collecting input driven. Everything you are collecting it, okay, there is something called as output driven. Okay, what I'll do is, boss, this is a Windows machine and I have three types of logs in Windows machine. Windows event viewer example. Oh, event viewer only, right? Event.
No, you can type EVENTWER.
Yeah, correct.
Command run.
Yeah, got it. Yeah, we got it. Just see this one. How many types of logs you have? Application logs, security logs, setup logs, system logs. Now what I'll decide is, in output driven, boss, I will send only security logs. I don't mind what is there in the application logs, like operating system application logs. I don't want operating system. If there is any like Apache or anything which I have installed, I will collect it in different folder. I'll take care of that. But from operating system side applications, like calculator, what it is doing, okay, Windows Media Player, what it is doing, all those things, stuff and all, I don't want. Okay, who installed what, I also don't want. Only who logged in, who logged out. Or say for example, extra, if I want like system logs, like someone has changed any registry values or something like that, those logs also I will take care. So security and system logs only I'll collect. This type of approach, the specifically what you want, that only you are collecting, right? That is called as output driven.
Can we call it as customization logs?
No, it is not customized. Everything you are collecting, but a set of logs. Only category of logs you are choosing yourself.
Okay.
Customization means that I'll explain it
okay.
later.
Okay.
Customization it is not. That is called as like
okay.
log modification. That I'll explain later. Okay. But for now, you remember this. Okay. Hi, Teja. The same thing which we discussed yesterday, I am explaining them in a different way. You guys can listen to it another half an hour to 45 minutes. You guys might be listening to the same content what I have already explained, but these guys they are joining with us, so that's why. Okay.
No
now
problem.
Yeah, just update Robin also regarding this. Okay, yeah, for half an hour he can join little late also, not a problem. Okay, so input driven is there, output driven is like what you want. I don't want input driven from all the system, all the application logs, all the system logs, all setup logs, all security logs, everything I'm taking. Okay, because I want it. I might be fear of missing something. Okay, sorry. Because if you use them also, sometimes you will not be in a position to use them in an effective way because of the input driven. But output driven is quite opposite. What I want, this is a strategy. You can collect only the logs that you have identified it is necessary for you. Okay, in the input driven. So you won't collect everything, the only required events which you want. Okay, and you can specify even in security also. Say for example, I want only successful event logs. I want only failure event logs. I don't want any some of other event IDs. Okay, only these events, if it is there, then I'll collect it. So that kind of thing CAL does, output driven. Okay, but there is, apart from these two, what is the disadvantage of this? There might be like important logs, you might be like, you consider it as something important, not important. Might be attacker might have like using that approach only, and from his side he's keeping, he's hampering those in that particular way where you are missing the logs. Okay, those locations where you are missing the logs. Okay, so you will be blind during that time because you are not getting those logs. You will not be able to. But here, having more too much also, you cannot focus on specific things. Unnecessary alerts will rise. You have to take care of them. All these headaches will also be there. Okay. Now, output driven, as I said, you might be missing some. That is a disadvantage. You might be missing some of them. Okay. Important things and not important. Attacker might be like going, getting into some system, and he might be installing some set of files. Those things you might be missing. I'm just giving example in a higher context. Don't take it in like, but what we, how we collect, how we take an approach towards the output driven. That's what I'm telling you guys. Okay, so that is the thing. So input driven and output driven. The third one is hybrid. Okay, in this hybrid method, instead of you use, like you collect everything, okay, you start removing some of the events slowly, okay, as soon as once you see some false alarm, false alert, just remove it. False alerts means like, these are not important for me. Why I'm getting some calculator related logs, I will remove it. Why I'm getting setup related, something related to some patches which are not at all to be focused, remove it. And I'll take some notification logs like battery or network throughput, that might be not required because NOC is already having that also. All these things I'm talking about the SIM. For SIM, what it is required, not for the complaints. Complaints you require everything. Okay, I'm talking about which logs you monitor for the SIM, like on the dashboard, what you want to see, what you want to raise an alert for, all those things. Okay, so those things. So what you'll do, you'll start taking the logs from all different machines, and you'll be doing like whatever unnecessary things, you'll be slowly getting rid of those unnecessary events, not the assets, events. Like I don't want to set up in that setup, this thing I don't want. So you will not be like monitoring them. You will not be monitoring them. Okay. So this type of like from everything to coming down, shortening those what you want. Okay. The view. Like what you want, viewing only what you want, that is called as tuning the logs. Tuning means you are fine tuning the logs, what you want you are just tuning, so that now you will get a bigger picture. That you first you collected everything and slowly you removed everything, like unnecessary things. Now you get the confidence, which and all are not required for me, slowly removed, like whatever it is required for the organization, I kept it from the SIM perspective. This is the ideal approach. Ideal approach. Okay. But if you are stuck here, then it is very hard for any organization to manage the things. If you are here, you might be under attack, but you are blind. Okay. because you are not seeing them, right? So that's why I'm saying you are blind. Okay. But here it is an ideal approach. This is a correct. That's what I said. Right amount of data, I said, right? Like too much, too less. This is a just right. Is this okay? You have to come to that position. Okay. So what is the main disadvantage of this? It requires tuning, means always maintenance is required. Like continuously you have to tune the locks. That is the only disadvantage of this. Okay. Here you might be missing, okay, lot of things, but with less resources you can start good amount of work here. Okay. So that's three different types of approaches where you can actually use for collecting the logs. Robin, it is like the same thing we are discussing. If you want, you can take half, like 30 minutes or something like that gap, so that I'll ping you. If you want, you can stay, but just telling same old thing I'm repeating. That's the reason. Okay. So then after some time we'll again get into the remaining aspects. Once syslog gets over, right, then I'll bring them back into our existing ongoing session. Okay. So this is the thing. So what kind of logs we are going to collect? That is the important thing now for us. So yes, we are collecting the logs. Any one approach you will take. Okay, as I said, let's go ahead with the hybrid approach only. Instead of this and that, let's go ahead with the hybrid approach. Okay, so what kind of logs we are going to collect? Guys, remember, these are the different types. OS logs, like Windows or Linux, anything. Or Linux. Okay. It can be a switch. Switch will also have a OS logs. Okay. But for the our reason, I'm just giving here. Switch, router, firewall, IDS, IPS. Okay. Then proxy. Then vulnerability scanner. Okay. And then app server logs. Okay. Then antivirus logs. Okay. Then
database.
Okay. Database.
Okay.
Active directory, and then vulnerability scanner. Okay, I already told you this, right? Okay, so still you can add. Still you can add. If you are companies like having VDIs, like virtual desktops, they have. Yeah. So definitely hypervisor. Okay, where all your virtual machines are installed, right? Those servers are called as hypervisors. Those framework is called as hypervisor. Those things. Okay. So, and your network logs. Here, like firewall traffic, you are talking about, and some network related, any security monitoring like threat intelligence. These IP address are not valid, or this port. I mean, like these URLs are not valid, some kind of thing, threat intelligence, okay, all those things. So these are different kind of logs you are going to collect it, okay. And I would like to say, okay, it's excellent. You have come up with this approach that you have to collect so many things, but how you will come to a conclusion that what's your SIM capacity should be? Like what should be your SIM capacity? Like there should be something like memory, how much processor, how much, okay, or this thing, what do you say, memory, processor, or RAM, everything, hard disk, RAM, everything. Hard disk means SSDs nowadays, all okay. Your system, how much capacity it should be. You take anything, you take ArcSight or Splunk or anything, this estimation is must. Okay, so now I'll tell you what is that. Okay, what I'll say here is this metrics, how you will come to know whether what is your capacity. It should be capacity. EPS means capacity. Okay. Events per second. How many events per second your SIM tool or your whatever you are using, the server which acts as a SIM, okay, has to process events. It can be a Windows event, it can be a Linux, I mean like a syslog event, or it can be a event, a traffic event from a Palo Alto server, it can be a snort log, or it can be a event. Event means event or log, both are same. If something gets happened over there as an event, it will convert into log, and that log only we are storing in the database. Event or log, both are same, can be interchangeably used also. Okay, don't get confused. Okay, events and logs, both are same. How many, that line, log line is called as an event. Okay, because of something happened in the organization, that's why it is generated one log. Okay, so how many events per second that has to process. Okay, that is called as capacity. That is called as capacity. Okay, capacity. So the conclusion, how you are going to do, simple way you have to do is, say Windows. Okay, take Windows. Okay, Windows is, say for example I'm telling 10 1 KB is a Windows each event line. Okay, size. Okay, switch is 0.5 KB. Okay, one event, just I'm giving, don't consider it as like as is. Okay, this is a 01 KB. Okay, something, just I'm just giving like this, you are getting. Okay, if you observe the size, how much data is there in each line of event is also getting changed. That's why different sizes are there. Correct, right? Okay, that also you have to consider. Okay, now as a blindly, what you will come to know is you will send all the logs of these systems. Select one day and send those logs. To the one server. To one server, some test server you take. Processing or doing anything, just storing it one day only. Maybe 1 TB or 2 TB data is enough for that. This is a database. Okay, not database, it is storage. Database is different and storage, like whatever I'm putting a file or something like that, right? That is a storage file in my hard disk. Database means you should have some structured or unstructured way of storing the data. Okay, this is storage. Okay, you sent it and you have come to know that all the logs in a day, easiest example is 1 billion logs you have collected for that one day, 1 billion logs you collected. Okay, so for one day, 1 billion logs you have collected. Okay, so now 1 billion you take it divided by, okay, per day how many seconds are there. Okay, per day how many seconds are there? Let's calculate. Calci. Okay, per minute 60, correct, right? Seconds into, I think 84,000 you will get something, and 60 into per 1 hour, it will be 60, that is 3600 into 24 hours we have total 86,400. So 86,400. Okay, 1 billion divided by 86,400, you will get some 11,000 something you will get. Okay, that means every second your server should process 11,000 events per second. That is the estimation. But is it an accurate estimation? Let's come to some scenarios. Okay, I said one scenario. You'll see these logs once we get into those dashboards creations and all. But just remember, morning times traffic, it will be less till 6 o'clock. This is 6 a.m. to 6 next day 6 a.m. I'm taking this 6 a.m. slowly it will rise this traffic like this, and by 10 it will be like this, and it will continue like this, and evening 6 a.m. it will be slowly reducing like this, and it will be like this. Next day it will be like this. Graphs will go like this, but you're seeing it. Just take this portion. Okay, so that means here peak value, how much that and all you have to make sure, like what is the peak value. Okay, so here how many events here, maybe 20,000 events might be happening. Okay, so that time automatically you have to increase your EPS to 20,000 events. You have to make sure. Okay, or this is one example how to estimate. Once after coming to this, you have to come to know. Okay, like how you have to further estimate. Okay, and this is the Monday business. This is the Tuesday business. This is the Thursday, Friday. Which day has got more traffic?
Friday.
So if you collected estimation for this day, okay, then your sim capacity will allow it to work on Friday properly?
Yeah.
No, right?
No.
Because it is more. Correct, right? Events per second.
Yeah.
Here it is. It might be like 30,000 or something. Correct, right? So that time sim, the CPS capacity will be overloaded, and your SOC operations might get hampered. Okay. So for that, you choose the correct day. You choose this day and start calculating. Okay. So 2 billion means maybe 22,000 EPS. Okay. On this day, if you take double the traffic. Okay. So that you will come to know, okay, 22,000 EPS. Okay. This is like business type you have calculated. But this is also certain extent something what you have to avoid. I'll tell why it is. You have to do more, okay, because you have to come to, like, you have to consider these things. And also sometimes, okay, you will be getting January in like this, it will be traffic, but if you see December, it will be like this more. So you have to well plan. That's why I'm telling, just looking at some things you don't get consider. You always focus on your peak, whichever your highest peak utilization will be there, right? Like there, that time your SOC operation should run smoothly even during those times. That's why your capacity should be estimated properly. So you take any data of, like, you try to calculate the December data and come to a conclusion. Okay, but will it satisfy? No, still you have to do some estimation. Example, okay, what if you have DDoS attack? Some DDoS attack has happened. Okay, all the logs will go to the router, right? Now you are collecting the router, but DDoS per second only, it will be like the DDoS main intention is what means. Let me just DDoS, DOS or DDoS. Okay, what it will be happening is the attacker will be sitting somewhere here. Okay, in DOS attack, he'll be sending some fake traffic to your web server just to hamper your service. If you are a very good e-commerce website, he wants to hamper your business. Maybe what's his intentions, it's out of context for now, but he wants to slow down your business. Okay, so he will send too much traffic from his machine to this. Okay, here you might be having some security service. As soon as when they come to know, okay, forget about whether it is there or not, the traffic is sent. Okay, so you have planned 10,000 events per second, something you have planned your SIM. This guy is sending 20,000 events per second from here. Now you are collecting the logs, all web request only, all web request only, and you have started collecting the logs. Now number of events which are getting recorded here, all your web server logs get generated, right? From this IP, this traffic is there, that you'll be recording right here. Those logs will be getting generated. So those things now 20,000 plus the SIM capacity only 10,000 from different systems, already logs are coming. But for this system only 20,000 logs are coming. Now this SIM fails to function. Slow down. Okay. You cannot access, you cannot write query. Everything is slow. Now you are blind. That's why I said most of the times I use word blind. Okay. So that is an issue. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to plan, like even attack happens, I consider maybe double the my capacity even if attack comes. Okay, then that's why whatever the estimation you do, right, say for here, say 20,000 events per second per a day into my entire organization, all the assets. Okay, all the assets, I might get 20,000 events per second, means into 3 you have to take, that is 60,000 events per seconds that system has to process. Okay, that capacity it is required. So for doing that, you will do some architecture, will do estimation, how much processor is required, what processor is required, okay, what SSD is required, how much terabytes of memory, okay, or how much petabytes of memory also, you can say it, okay. So what is your size, RAM, how much size, all those things, your processor, RAM, and SSDs, what you are going to use, all those things you will start estimating based on this value. Is it clear or not? EPS.
Yes, sir.
100%.
Yes.
Okay. So that is the estimation how to come. Now it is clear, right? Every organization, if you get inside, if they ask you, very new to, you are very new to organization, you can give all these inputs to them. If they are planning to go for a SIM, then if they have hired you, you have to give, sir, we have to estimate like this. This is the approach. Okay. This is the thing. We have to go for this. We have to consider this. All these things you have to update them. Okay, minimum how many? 3 times it is at least you have to consider. Okay, now then basically if you follow this approach, you will come to a fair amount of understanding. Okay, so how you have to do it, usually it's an architect task, but still you can. Okay, and remember, okay, the capacity when you are planning, you have to plan for like cold storage also. Like, I mean, like this, it will be like hot storage. This is like hot data, which is this cold data. As I said earlier, like only main SIM how much it has to store. Once OfterSync stores it, you have to push it to archive. Okay, where the archive will be storing for years together, maybe 5 years or something like that for auditing and all. Okay, that is like cold storage, like zipped format, everything you'll put here, an unzipped format it is. Okay, all those events. Yeah. So that you have to remember. Okay, now there are what type of, go ahead.
Here 20,000 into 3, the buffer is per day, right?
No, per second. That's why I'll explain here. Okay. 2 billion.
Per second.
2 billion events per second. You are dividing with how many number of second, how many events you require per second.
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
So that is the thing. Okay. So now you have to. Yes, then you will do the remaining things and all, like what is the database, okay, storage, okay, it's not database, and what is the processor it required, and what is the RAM it required, okay, all those things you will estimate, and then you will start working on that machines for SOC. Okay, now let us come back to our other things. Don't save it. Okay, now now people, okay, there are three different roles in SOC. Okay, now you have planned it and you bought, configured everything. Okay, the SIM is there, either any one of SIM which we discussed earlier, you kept there, and you have now approach, like what is the strategy you have to follow, either input driven, output driven, or hybrid, which is the correct approach? I mean, ideal approach?
Hybrid,
yes. Okay. And you have to make distinguish. Someone ask you if they doesn't know what is hybrid, you have to tell, take one system example and tell him that if I want consider all the logs, then it will be like input driven. If I take only system logs alone, our security logs alone, that is this thing, but in hybrid I'll collect all the logs, and say for example in system logs I don't want to see any logs which are generated after the reboot or something like that, those things I won't consider. I will see only the registry related changes logs, those things only I'll consider. So I'm very focused on what events I want to know, remaining things and all I will tune, I will won't monitor, I won't consider, okay, for my SIM. Okay, so now the resources have come into the picture. Okay, resources. Okay, okay, the first one is L1. Okay, now what is the task of any L1? What is the task of any L1? You have L1. Oh, sorry guys, L1, L2 and L3. L1 is responsible to, like you have created a lot of dashboards, okay, in your Splunk
organization.
Okay, for your organization. Okay, and he'll be monitoring all those dashboards. So these are the dashboards. These are the Windows server logs. This is web server logs. Okay, well, so many will be there. Like this is one page I'm giving. There will be hundreds of pages in some companies. Okay, and some dashboards will display list of some events, top IP addresses from where the traffic is coming. So in table format also you'll be viewing them. With the stats we'll say usually. Okay, let it be in table formats also you'll be viewing top IP address from which country, where it is second top, third top, top 10 you are watching, something like that. Here are some graphs you might be seeing. Okay, like what is happening with the current traffic, all those things you'll be viewing it here. like what is the health? Health should be always most of the times it should be like this perpendicular. I mean like horizontal line. Okay. If there is anything health is reducing, means you will immediately check. If there will be some options here in the dashboard, just click them and go and see different time ranges you select and you see it. In Splunk, we'll see it later. Okay. All those things here. L1 will be seeing like this, and he's got some mail configured. Okay. His account is configured some mail, and you have some alerts also here somewhere, some other box you have, you'll be having some main dashboard he created himself for his own. Any alerts are there for the SOC, he'll be monitoring that also, somewhere it is there, and he'll be having mail also either from here, or because he's monitoring here, he opened it and he's monitoring that internally what is happening, something he's monitoring. So now he doesn't have this view, so he'll be monitoring it. So he doesn't come to know that event, some alert is there somewhere, options here which shows that alert is there and all, but he is ignored. So what will, what, how, there is one mail will be triggered and it will come over here, that he'll see it, no mail pop up or something like that. Then he'll go through and see that. He'll do the first level of investigation. L1 does what? First level of investigation. Okay. Just remember this. Okay. This is the first level of investigation what he'll do. Okay. He has told that alert is whether it is false positive or not, till that extent he will check if it is there. Okay. If there is further processing of that particular request, investigation he has to do, like first basic investigation, someone has clicked on some link which some antivirus identified that it is a malware. Okay, immediately alert raised. Okay, then alert came, then you went checked, means like your L1, you checked what has happened. This is so and so antivirus. This is like signature is this. All those things will be there in the antivirus logs. You will monitor them and you will record them in the incident ticket. All that information you will be writing it here. Like we'll see it later, but remember like what is the attack? Okay. From which source? What is the host mission under the attack? Means like. Where the attack has happened, that particular PC name, okay, and what is the IP, host IP, host name, host IP, okay, and you will check what is the IP reputation, okay, what is IP reputation, let me show you something, okay, if you go to IP void, okay, blacklist check is there. Example, IP void blacklist. Just I give IP void. That's enough. Okay. Now, my IP address I want to check. My IP address. Take this copy. Automatically it came. Okay. No need to worry. I'll check it. What is my reputation of my IP address? Whether, okay, see, this is like something blacklisted 2 out of 115. Okay, who are blacklisted my IP address? Let me check. Okay, CBL abuse, I don't know who is it. Okay, Mali spike, someone. Okay, let me know that some this system has actually told that I am. Jedmailspike.org, maybe some mails or something I might have sent for that. They might have DNS related queries that this and all I'll be doing, right? So maybe because of that, they might be considered me as suspicious. Okay, so then CBL something it is there, that also I'll go and check. Whether I'm human or not, it will be asking. These are some websites which helps us to know that what is like IP address and IPYID is some website which gives various vendors who are tracking the blacklisted IPs, right? My IP address, whether any one of those which it is tied up, right? Any of them are actually blocked me or not. Say, for example, I will say Kaspersky, or I can say, oh, that is the other thing. Sorry, that is VirusTotal. Okay, so different IP whitelisting companies, these are, okay, which are good and which are bad. IP addresses, these guys will be having. If you are getting like not only one or two, but if you are getting many, if you are observing too many, even one is there also, you have to say that, sir, in that particular list you have to write saying that, okay, IP reputation, like your company might have given some tool, okay, or some URL, whichever the company gives, use that only, okay, IP reputation tool. And tell that what is the reputation of the IP from where the request means source, from where the source IP address, from where this traffic has come, right? That particular reputation of traffic source that you have to properly write, means whether it is like how many blacklisting it is displayed in the website where your company is tied up, right? IP reputation. So there, how many IP addresses are actually blocked or all those things, okay? All those things you will write, okay? And then if it is antivirus, your antivirus is detected, okay? Now what I'll do, I'll go in, see, your company might also given some virus total kind of virus, right? Virus total means it identified that it is a threat, your antivirus, like your organization, okay? Is there any organization that identified this is a threat? Say, for example, sample virus signature, okay? I'll take this virus signature. I'm not able to copy. Okay, test file. Okay, I'm opening it now. Give me a second. Okay, so let me take, these are the virus file hash. Means some virus file was there. That is actually converted into hash file. Let me take that sample thing, go here, okay, or take any file, okay? I'll choose one file, okay? What I'll do is I will go to some, definitely I know that Bandicam, as I said earlier, there is key generator is there, definitely this might be having some virus. I'll just upload that. Okay, whatever the attacker, I mean like your user has clicked the file, right? That file you will upload. Make sure the company provided similar kind of tool only use, don't use VirusTotal. Okay, just tell in interview, you can tell this, okay? You uploaded it, okay? Now this particular file, and it converted into some hash, okay? It converted into some hash, you know, right? What is hash? Hash is also kind of encryption, but it is one way. It will just generates one random string, not random string, using the algorithm, it generates some string, okay? If you take the same file, okay, anywhere, okay, use the same algorithm, generate, it will produce same thing. If you modify a single line, like space also, if you modify or something you change, it will give some different hash, I mean like hash value. So now this virus file, whatever I've got, or some file which I thought like suspicious, I uploaded and I got this hash, and it compared with its database hash, okay, and come to know that the database hash and my hash file compared, and it identified that these many, say both are same, right? 077077, both are same, okay? In that database this hash is there, and how many of the like antivirus service providers or different companies have flagged this. Antivirus manufacturers or security companies have actually, see, these are the companies, Adware, Alibaba, these are the companies, okay, Kaspersky, EST, okay, Malwarebytes, okay, even you can use Malwarebytes also for doing such things. Usually many companies use Malwarebytes as this thing, and you can tell in the in your company that Virus Total, okay, we have the premium subscription of Virus Total, like that you tell, okay, Symantec, okay, McAfee, okay, Sophos, okay, so many companies are there, almost all companies will be there here. So almost all companies, they found suspicious, this is a Trojan, this is a backdoor, malicious application keygen, Windows Trojan, like that they have flagged it, okay. So this is like the details, if you go more details you'll be having it on that. If you want you can read what kind of impact, okay, what are the file only feed in different ways, what kind of attacks it does, that also explanation will also be there. Behavior, see here it, they have written what kind of behavior, where and all it will go, and it will hamper shell, RPC remote protocol. I mean, like RPC means like it will be connecting with its main server somewhere and starts communicating in a secured way, okay. Then that kind of thing, something, okay. So you will get to know like whether strongly now you believe that this is an attack. So all these steps, who does? L1 does, and he puts all that information, gives it to whom? L2. Okay, now what is L2 task? L1 has done enough amount of the thing. Now L2 task is to start digging more deeper into the activities, okay, what it is. Is this attack happened here only, or L2 will now you will assign it to L2, and that person name or something you will assign it, whoever is there in the office at that particular moment, okay, he will receive it. He might be doing some dashboard work or something like that. All of a sudden, along with, he'll be like involved in creating dashboards, alerts, okay, all these things will be doing, reports he'll be sending, all these things he'll be doing. Apart from that, the L1 has done some investigation and he assigned it to you in the incident report. This is the incident report, okay, incident report. Now you will take that and it is assigned on your name in ServiceNow or somewhere, okay. Now what you will do is you will start doing further investigation. What is that further investigation, okay? Now is this traffic from this particular source only from this machine, or any other machine there is a traffic already came, or from past 1 month how many times he attacked this system or any other system in the organization, okay? If he has done it, what kind of traffic, all such investigation L2 does, and he updates it in the same incident report as his inputs, okay? And then he will ask the like antivirus team to resolution what you have to, you will, they'll be giving you resolution related information, suggested resolution. You should not, that IT will take care, but it is suggested resolution you will be assigning. Once they, whatever the decision they take, IT team, whether they will format the machine or they will be removing the network and all those things, and they will be like everything, whatever, like blocking the traffic from that, everything they will take care. You suggest everything. Once they do that, then you close that ticket. That might take within like 1 hour or 1 day or something like that. Okay, that time, since it is assigned, they will update in the service now what they have done. Based on that, you can close the ticket. Okay, and you have, that is what the L2 role. Now L3 role, what it is the L3 role? Okay, incident L2. Okay, let me just put. Guys, are you able to get, or I'm just going little fast?
Yeah, following.
Okay, there is one Telugu.
Inter,
go ahead.
If the attack is false positive, then that ticket can be closed in L1 bin only, right?
Yes, correct. No traffic, because of like no traffic only from there. Okay, you will update it. That's it. Okay, and you will put the priorities also, P1 or P2 or P3, something like that. That also you will put. Okay, and the severity also you will put. That and all we'll see later. Now we'll just getting the knowledge right now. Now L3's main responsibility is he has to take care of how many incidents open, any backlogs are there, like which investigations have to be done, whether why they are not closing, all those follow-ups, backlogs, follow-ups. Okay.
Any challenges?
Yeah, challenges. Means blocks, blockades. Okay. And weekly reports. Even L2 only will send, but this has to be approved by L3. Okay. Most of the cases. Okay. And like meeting with the stakeholders, who network team, firewall team, all those things, all those guys, like new rules, anything has to be written. Okay, all those things, what are the plans for that, he will get the work and he will give it to L2. Okay, by discussing with them, and apart from that, managing the resources. Guys, is it clear till here?
Yeah.
Because Robin and these guys have already involved, okay, but I'm just putting it more context. Anyhow, they are also listening, right? So that's why I'm adding some more things here, so that they also, this time they can also be utilized, okay, for that purpose. Okay, so these are the things what L3 will be doing, manager will be doing. Okay. So guys, these are different types of things that in an organization happens, okay, in day to day, okay, above with respect to the resources. Okay, now let's wipe this off. We don't require anything now. Okay, clear, right?
Raghav, who will provide a security awareness to the employees, L2 or L3, in case?
No, it is not like that. If it is like some hardware or some software, okay, vendor will provide to certain extent. If there are external trainings, external people like Splunk, you want to learn more, like writing the queries in a better way, you opt to that training. Sometimes one of the L2 or L3 who are having better knowledge, they will arrange the training. It's not like only L3 or L2 will provide it. It's like how the manager manages the team, what kind of liberty he gives it to the team, and what kind of he'll be taking care of the shift timings also. Because if your company is working 24/7 SOC, then he will be the one who takes care of decision, like this is your shift, night shift, who has to come in day, and the rotation of the shift.
That is not my question.
Mm.
Actually, security awareness in the sense if something, a phishing mail attack or ransomware attack happened to the organization, SOC team only need to give some awareness to the people.
No, it is not like that. SOC team only won't give. If something attack organization wise, it is anything big impact, means you will update it to the CISO. You will update it to the CISO. CISO will have under him, some people will be there. They will broadcast it to the entire organization, but not SOC. SOC is responsible only with the stakeholders, like directly we interact with firewall team, we interacting with them, who application server team, because they are our customers. For SOC, they are our customers. We are serving them because they need some security. We are providing it. Okay, but organization level, if something bad happened, we have identified it, but we should not just broadcast it to anyone. Okay, we have to update it to our CISO. CISO will take, Chief Information Security Officer will take care of that, because it's not like important. I mean, like, it's not advisable that to spread anything on our own. Let the CISO is there to take the decision. He will take it. Usually, there will be something called as I forgot the name. Security.
No.
Security bulletin they'll be releasing. Okay. Some companies, SOC team only will release the security bulletin. Like what they will do, they will go here. Okay. This is also important. Just remember. EVE MITRE. Okay. MITRE. Okay, here you will see organization, like overall world. Okay, what are the
common vulnerability exposure?
So where I can see CVE list. Okay, you can see here. Okay, looking it back. Okay, you will see this like in the Twitter or somewhere they'll be like, if you register to them, you will get their feeds. Okay, MITRE feeds, CVE, common vulnerabilities, whatever it is there, it will come out. Okay, and immediately you will take that information, what it is, an issue was discovered on LG mobile device with Android OS 8.0 or 8.1 or 9 with 10 software. BT manager means like Bluetooth manager allows attackers to bypass intended access restrictions on a certain mode. Okay, some mode, if it is some mode, it is allowing to attackers to access the Bluetooth. Now, is it applicable for me or not? First of all, you should know. You'll go and check the assets list. Okay. In that, first of all, your organization has provided any Android devices to their employees or not, because some business related task or testing related task, some companies will allow give mobiles to their companies. In that, LG mobile is there or not? If it is there, whether it is Android 8.0, 8.1 or 9.0 is there or not, that also it will check, or 10, anyone is there or not. Yes, if it is there, then immediately what you will do, okay, to that group who and all are using, right, for them, you will send an advisory. Okay, you will send an advisory. Advisory means it is about the information. Okay, what you say? Security advisory. Okay, template. Let me. Let me open. Yeah, notice something has come, right? It should be like this. Like some common vulnerabilities there. Okay. If patch is there, then you can apply. But that attack only observed now. Whether it has got a fix means LG has to do fix for that. Okay, LG takes some time to fix this, maybe 1 day or 2 days or 1 month, or we don't know what it is the time. So you will tell that advise not to enable the Bluetooth. Okay, like that you will update it. And some, if it already patches is there, means you will update the patches. Okay, and you will make sure like to update those. So you will make sure they you advise them to disable it, so it will impact. If it is very critical data in those mobiles, then you will take a consent from the employees that they are not going to enable the Bluetooth or something like that. Or you will ask your IT team if there is any settings control option, like something called as bring your own device BYOD features will be installed, where the settings can also be controlled from a remote server. Google settings of a device can be controlled if it is a corporate account. That options they will give. You can disable Bluetooth from settings itself, from sitting from the remote server. Okay, and you can send this advisories, important advisory. Until unless this gets fixed, we are not enabling Bluetooth like that. You will send an advisory. Okay, so advisory means some intimating the people who might get impacted. See, there is a like Adobe CV. Okay. Say Adobe, there is something has come, I guess. Adobe Reader CV latest. Okay. Let me check when it was the latest. Yeah. This is a March, you have seen this. I don't want like this. TV MITRE. Okay, let us see this only. Product wise. Okay. Here also it is not updated. List. Okay, when was this? But I think there is a advisory happened like 2020, that is just some days before, like 2020, maybe 8th or 7th or something, advisory has came saying that some Adobe related attacks are happened. So there was some advisory, something, some companies they will get it. Okay, so this is this is called as like the advisory. It's not like SOC will take care, but it's not restricted to the SOC, but people in SOC can also do that. But usually CU office, some people will actually keep monitoring them, and CISO office, sorry, some employees will be monitoring them. They will be advising because they will run the security posture, right? Governing side, all those things. Okay, so that is the reason. Okay, so that is the thing. Is it cleared for you? What doubt you have asked?
Yes.
Okay. So some other few things we will see. Now let's get into, no, not this. Yeah. Okay, let's get into this now. So now let's talk about this SIM. Okay. SIM. SIM is a just complete everything together SIM. Okay. It's not like only that hardware, whatever it is lying down, is not the SIM. SIM means it is an ecosystem. Like you will have multiple components together to form. So what are different components? It's like you will have multiple modules, parts will be there in the SIM. The first one is what, for everything from some system, some logs has to be sent to the location of the like your Splunk indexer or something, means someone should be able to collect it, right? So collector should be there, where, at the device side. Okay, so collector, log collector is there, log collector. Okay, just remember, I'll explain this. There are two types, agent or agent based log collector, or agent less anyone, or script something. Okay, Agentless means some scripts you will be using by default. Okay, remove it. You are pushing, okay, or some scripts. This is the first thing. You need a log collector. You need, then I'll take log aggregator. Okay, this will take care of adding context. Okay, which type of log it is, from where, which source it is coming, all that information will be added. This will might also be there at the collector side only. Okay, means like from where the logs are sending, right, on that machine only, this might also be there. Okay, just remember that point also. And then you have log broker. Okay, what is log broker? I'll explain. This is a temp storage within a site. Site means geographical location, something. Okay, then storage means this is like ultimately in whatever the SOC environment you have, this SIM hardware is there, right? In that storage, okay, the actual storage where your indexer and all are getting stored, right? Where your indexer will be there, right? That storage, this is, okay, example indexer, cool. Where indexer side for Splunk. There might be some other architecture, some other naming convention will be there, how they store, but for Splunk I'm just giving this, just remember that. Then this is, there is three important parts of the Splunk. What are they?
Indexer, forwarder,
search and report is the functionality, correct, right? You can search it and you can create a dashboard or reports, correct, right? Ultimately you have a, like, dashboard is also nothing but a report, but it will be lying over there as in the form of a link. When you click it, it will display that. But report is a file which you can store it and you can share it with others. Okay, now search and reporting is also one component, because if you are having only the logs, then what it will become? It will become a compliance device, which is like you cannot do anything. Okay, till only storage, if it is, or just if you like only search or anything is there, means it is, if it only search you can do and you cannot do create report also, it is a compliance. Even if you have report, but it is not like any extensive way you can create the reports, means also it will be a compliance device. But everything, fulfillment of SIM happens only when there is a alert mechanism. So alert engine should be there. Alert engine should be there. Okay, got it?
Yes.
Okay, now I'll explain one by one each device. Okay, now log collector you have. Ravin, you're listening?
Yeah.
Okay, you might get bored. Okay, bear with it.
No worries.
Okay. So, this is a log collector. So, this is a machine. Okay. So, this is a PC. Now, from here, what you're doing is you're sending the logs to some other machine. Okay. So for example, now I want to collect the logs from this machine. Okay, machine, this is an application server. Okay, so first of all, one layer will be there on top of it. Correct, right? Like definitely the first layer is operating system. It means machine directly comes, means it will come, like you will install operating system. So OS logs, okay, they are getting in some folder. So some folder like event viewer we have seen, right? For Windows, for Linux you have syslogs. Okay, some folder logs will be getting stored. Okay, logs will be getting stored in some folder. So I'll just give here. Oh, sorry. I'll just say it as L. That's it. I don't say anything. I'll just say our logs. I'll give like this. I'll just give logs are getting stored here. All whatever it is happening in the Windows, they are storing logs here. Okay. So this is a first source. Okay. If you are installing some Apache or any other, like this OS will have system apps. Those are also logs here only. Some other applications related to the operating system, like as I said, calculator or your DNS or your some other thing, everything will get stored here only. Remember, okay. I just want to clarify one thing. All operating system, when you install anything like operating system, whether Linux or Windows, all the logs will get stored here only. Okay, it can be a event viewer for Windows. Say for example, event viewer for viewing, but there will be some other module. I don't remember the name, but we can view from event viewer. Windows events will have some location. Windows event storage some location, but Linux has got syslog. All the system logs, security logs, kernel logs, application logs of the operating system, everything will get stored. Okay, for Linux or Unix. Why I'm saying Unix? Still people use Unix. Okay, because like very old companies, they'll be running a lot of devices, right? Mainframes, that, this, and all, they are on Unix only. Okay. Now, this is the thing. Now, what you have done is you have this system is actually meant for serving some web pages. That is like this is entire top part. This entire outer layer is like some web application server. So the main purpose is web server. Some web server. So you will be creating some. Like you developed and kept it, but for those also some logs will be created by the developers. Remember, by the development team of that, they might have created some log, something like created some logs, like generating logs, they will take care and they will put it in some folder. Okay, that helps you from where you have to take logs. Okay, these are nothing but which logs? Okay, that's why I kept it outside OS. Okay, means that doesn't mean that it's not like we are not taking those logs. Okay, we are not merging these two logs as the same. Okay, so for example, this is an Apache logs. Okay, just you consider this Apache or Nginx or anything. Okay, and these logs are this. Okay. Now logs are getting generated. Okay. Now what you'll do is you will send only the logs. Okay, only the logs to be collected here. Okay. Here. Okay. What you'll do is the logs have to be sent now. Okay. On this machine. Okay, logs are getting collected. Okay, so you will be installing something called as agent in the machine. Okay, agent. Okay, for collecting these logs, you need one agent. Okay, which understand these logs. And for collecting Apache logs, you need one more agent.
Now, why we need two agents?
I'll explain. Okay, now you have two agents. Okay, I'll explain why. Okay, what I'm telling, you are collecting the logs, correct, right? You are collecting the logs. Okay, now this logs, whatever you have collected, okay, now the second part, what I said is to be aggregated, means to be adding, we should add some context to it. Okay, we should add context to it. Now let me show you something. Okay, take Splunk application server, Splunk forwarder. Okay, you take this Splunk forwarder. Okay, types you select like this. Okay, I don't want to put lot of things. Okay, okay, here I don't want, just remember, like raw logs, parsed logs, unparsed logs, all those things are there. But let me show you, like, okay, here universal forwarder is there. If you use like everything, it will collect, but heavy forwarder, light forwarder, all these things are there. Okay, means what you want, you can forward them. Okay, but easiest way is ArcSight, it will give you better. I'll just show you ArcSight. Okay, connectors. Okay, connector types. Okay, connector, connectors list, which, yeah, okay, products. Okay, yeah, this is enough. We'll see this. Okay, now this is a connector, is an agent. Just for your sake, I'm just referring this document, because Splunk, the documentation is messy, so that's the reason I'm giving this. Okay, now for antivirus, okay, you brought, okay, you installed it, okay, on your machine. Say for example, antivirus, you installed it on your machine, Windows server, you installed it. Okay, now Windows logs to forward, okay, you have one connector. Okay, when you installing that, you have to select what type of device it is. It will give list of devices. Okay, so you have to select that device, only one device only you have to select from that list. Okay, it's same way like forwarder only, but for your understanding I'm giving this. Right, connector installation guide. If I show you, for easy way, for your understanding only I'm giving this. Don't consider, because we use most of the times universal forwarders, right, for everything to send. So now if you see, no, I want connector. Okay, see this. Okay, ArcSight manager is selected. Okay, now go forward, admin username password you enter, everything okay. Now ArcSight, now everything you move forward, and NSV, no, okay. CF format, where it is, man. Yeah, where and all it is, There should be some way where you'll be selecting from the list. I think first only you'll select it. I'm not able to get it. No, 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 no. Let me see, ArcSight Manager encrypted. Because what you'll do is you'll just you will select the path from where the logs has to be selected, because I just want to show you which file format it is you are sending. Okay, I don't want that to where you are sending. Okay, forwarder only will take, but it will be messy. Okay, here first theory wise I'll explain you here. Okay, first you want to, you have Windows Microsoft server is there, that is 2003 or 2012 or something server is there. Okay, on top of that inside you have installed some antivirus. Okay, that is the F-Secure antivirus you have installed. Two things are there now. Okay, now I want to forward the logs. Okay, now Windows events, I know some location will be there. Okay, so when I am installing yesterday also I have universal forwarder. Okay, Splunk. If I say here, all the Windows logs, whatever it is happening, forwarder, installation, step by step. I think on that day also we struggled a lot to get this, but let us check. No, God. Okay. Okay, so what you have two options. Okay, one is universal forwarder, which only takes care of the operating systems based logs whichever you have. Okay, but remaining and all you have to use a light forwarder. Okay, or you have to use heavy forwarder, means those are different types of connectors, means collecting mechanisms will get changed, means some specific application logs I have to send. Like antivirus or those things that you have to use these light or heavyweight for heavy forwarders. You have to use Splunk forwarder. Okay, let me show you difference between Splunk universal forwarder and heavy forwarder. Okay. The capabilities of Splunk, you know, simultaneously heavy forwarder send data like universal, and also parse the index. No, not that. I want installation step by step, because when you are installing the connector, only one port and one location can only be provided during the installation. You cannot provide this port. Okay, all those things you cannot provide, only one port only you can provide, or else let us try to install connector universal forwarder. Is there anywhere universal forwarder? Let me take step by step. If I click images, I'll click. Yeah, select that. You are giving IP, okay, and port of the system. I want Splunk answers. Okay, where is this APA agreement? Select this locations. This location you are giving, right? This location you are giving, right? your installation folder. This is a password. Your credentials you are giving. This is a certificate. This is a local server. Okay. Okay. Now, if you see here, you are selecting the location, then you are entering other credentials, and slowly if you go here, where it is, deployment server means like that is also Splunk server. Yeah, here. Now you tell me.